Hi, and welcome to Run Tall with Tim, the YouTube channel that's dedicated to all runners everywhere. I'm Tim, and I upload new running videos every single week. Today, I'm bringing you a shoe from Adidas. It's their Adizero Adios Pro. Now, this shoe I've been trying to get a hold of for several weeks with really no success at all. The minute the shoe would get released, it seemed like it sold out long before I was able to pick up a pair. But I finally did get my hands on some, and I'm excited to share with you my experience in them. Well, before we get too far, though, as I have done with other videos in the past, if you want to skip around to the parts of the video that are just of interest to you, so maybe save yourself a little bit of time, I did try to make it easy for you. So I created chapters. All you have to do is open the description and then click on the timestamp for the part of the video that you want to watch, and it's going to take you right there. Before we get into the discussion of the shoe, I put together a run demo for you. So let's take a look at that. And then when we get back, we're going to go into great detail about the Adios Pro. So I had a lot of fun running out in this shoe today. I went a little over 11 miles, and I wasn't trying to crush it, but I wanted to see what this shoe could do underfoot. So I took it into a variety of different surfaces. I ran on some pavement, some concrete, as well as some dirt. And so let's just dive right in and start talking about the shoe. One of the reasons I was so excited to get my hands on it is when it was released and got on the feet of some elite athletes, world records were being broken in the half marathon distances. And so that was really intriguing to me. That, and I had run in the Adizero Pro earlier over the summer, which is a completely different carbon plated racing shoe altogether, much lower stack height. And in that shoe, you're standing basically right on top of the carbon fiber plate. So when I heard about this shoe and I could see for myself that these records were being broken, I really could not wait to get my hands on it. And, it's been selling out just as fast as they've hit the shelf, so to speak, and for good reason. I can see why now that I've had a chance to put them on my feet. So let's talk about it. It's $200, $200 US. But you know what? That's pretty much on par. And I think it's a bargain compared to shoes like what Nike has out. So you got the Nike Next Percent. Let's face it, that shoe has set the standard for speed and distance for a few years now. And the Alphafly that came out recently. But this shoe is definitely right in that category. And at $200, it's considerably cheaper, but it's certainly on par with its performance. And I think for other shoes in its category or price range, it's really a standout. So shoes like the Saucony Endorphin Pro, which I know is loved by a lot of runners, the Hoka Carbon X, the Hoka Rocket X that just came out. So, you know, this shoe, or even the New Balance RC Fuel Cell RC Elite, you know, all of those shoes. I think this one is just, it feels to me like it's going to be a step above that. It certainly has its sights set on, you know, maybe taking the next percent down a peg or two. Now, looking at the weight of this shoe, on my scales for a men's 8.5, it came in at 7.5 ounces or 214 grams. And this is one of those times when I did order a half size down. If you've seen my shoe reviews in the past, you know that typically I'm ordering a men's size 9. But I ran in the Adizero Pro earlier this summer, and I felt like that shoe was just a little big and that I could get away with going a half size down, which is what I did this time. Now let's take a look at the upper. You know, as we zoom in and get a real close look, we can see that it's made of a cellar mesh material. It is translucent. You can see right through it. So it's highly breathable. It's kind of got this diamond shape pattern into it. It really doesn't have any plastic overlays to speak of. You can see the Adidas stripes on the side of the shoe as we work our way around back to that heel counter. Now let's talk about the eyelet chain. Now this is a bit unusual. So, you know, usually a lot of times I don't have a whole lot to say about an eyelet chain other than, you know, it's holding your laces. But in this case, you know, they have an extra set of eyelets on the one side of the shoe to give you more lacing options. Now I have not fooled around or tinkered around with any of that so far because just a standard lace has been fine for me. But you do have that option. So if you do want to mess around with that to see if you can obtain even a better or more secure lockdown feeling for yourself, you certainly have that ability to do that here. And I do appreciate that. Anytime that you can have more options to customize a shoe to help it fit you and your style of running better, I think that's a good thing, especially with something as simple as an eyelet chain. Let's look at the tongue of the shoe. You know, this is really kind of interesting as well. You know, on the one side, it's kind of a semi-gusseted tongue, but on the other side, they got it sewed in or tacked in. So it's a full gusset on one side and then a semi on the other side. It's a kind of a leathery type of a material, or, you know, I don't know, maybe neoprene might be a good description for it, but it's very smooth texture to it. It's got a couple little pieces or places where it has a bit of padding, but, you know, with it being gusseted like it is, you know, it's not going to migrate around anywhere onto your foot, so it's going to lay nice and flat. Now, the only issue that I had at all was when I was just trying to put the shoe on. You know, it seemed to get caught up just a little bit. So it took a little bit of tugging here and there, but eventually I did get it on. And once it's on, it fits great. Really snug across my midfoot. I love that feeling. You know, this is a shoe where there's really not that kind of stretch in the upper material. So you can get yourself locked right in without any kind of issue at all. So let's zoom around and we'll look at the padding around the heel collar and tab of the shoe. You know, it's very minimal. It's what you would expect in a carbon plated racing shoe. It's plenty to keep you comfortable. I didn't have any issues with that at all, especially with a first run. Sometimes on a first run experience, I can get some hot spots, but I didn't have that issue at all here. It's got kind of a split tab for your Achilles to kind of set in the back as well. And that felt comfortable. I didn't have any issues with that at all. Looking at the heel counter, you know, there's not a ton of structure here. You can see as I pinch it together, there's really none on the sides, but they do have a piece of plastic that runs up the center of that heel counter that does give it a little bit of structure. But you know what? I didn't need that much. This is an incredibly stable shoe, far more than I ever expected it to be. A part of that is when I saw how tall that stack height of foam was underfoot. So let's look at that midsole now. It's got 39 millimeters in the heel and 31.5 millimeters in the forefoot. So it's got that 8.5 mil drop from the heel to the toe. That is so much foam. That was in the area that I was kind of concerned about. I was excited to run in it, but I was a little concerned that it might be unstable because I tend to overpronate. And you can get those tall stack heights, and that can sometimes amplify that problem for me. But I did not, to my surprise, that was not an issue at all. This is an incredibly stable shoe to run in. And it has their Light Strike Pro foam material that they're using. And interestingly enough, now they have different tech for the carbon plate in the shoe. They actually have a carbon plate that's in the heel, but then they have energy rods that are in the forefoot of the shoe up to the toe. So if this were your foot, the energy rods would mimic the bones, those metatarsal bones in your foot. And so you're going to have more give when you run. And with as much foam that's underfoot, what surprised me probably the most is that, I felt when I first put them on and I was just walking in a shoe, there was a ton of cushion. And I thought, oh, I might be feeling like I'm running on a sponge here or even a mush or cloud-like type feeling. But that was not the case at all. When I took off running, I was pleasantly surprised at the amount of responsiveness that I was getting. And I was, basically midfoot striking. At times I was up on my forefoot, but mainly I'm a midfoot striker. And the amount of bounce back, pop, snap back, however you want to refer to it, was a bit jarring at first. I wasn't expecting it. Not at all. I just thought with all that foam, I kind of had in my mind that it was going to be a much more plush, cushier ride. And that's not what I got at all. So it was a pleasant surprise. And as a result, I found that I wanted to run faster than I was intending to. And so the shoe just wants to go fast. Now, when I said in the beginning that I wasn't out trying to crush it, and that's because I'm training for a half marathon, and today's workout was a simple one. It was just a longer run. I was to warm up for a couple minutes, run 11 miles, cool down for a couple minutes, and try to keep a pace around a 9-15 minute mile. Just a nice, easy, long run. But I ended up coming in around 8:30. Now that's not lightning fast, but keep in mind I was trying to run slower, and I kept having to dial it back and dial it back. Every time I look at my Garmin, I would say, "Oh, I'm not supposed to be going that quick," but the shoe just wants to go that fast. And there are times when I did pick up the pace because I just couldn't resist. You've got this basically a set of racing tires on your feet, and you want to try them out. And I certainly did, and they felt awesome. So I'm excited to try these out on one of my speed workout days to just see exactly what I can do when I'm really trying to put the pedal to the metal. So that'll be fun. So let's flip the shoe over. You can see it's basically a racing slick. If this were a racing car, it'd be, racing tires kind of on that bottom that's covering up that Light Strike Pro foam and protecting it. But they have an ample amount there. They got it around the heel and they got it up in the forefoot. Some more testing and I'll have a better idea of the durability and how that's going to last. But under the different environments that I had it in, it performed well. And part of the reason I took it out into that that gravel area that you saw me running in is because for the half marathons that I run, they almost all have a trail type component to them. I'll start out, I'll be running on, running right down the middle of the city, on pavement, but then eventually it'll turn off into a park trail or something along those lines. Or it might start in a vineyard somewhere or what have you, but there's always seems to be a dirt component to the half marathons that I run. And so I wanted to see what this shoe could do or how it was gonna feel. With that basically racing slick, simple outsole material, was I going to feel unsafe when I was trying to pick up the pace? And the good news for me is I did not. And I didn't feel any of those stones or pebbles underfoot. So it was not uncomfortable to run on that dirt. So that was a real pleasant surprise for me as well. Hey, I really enjoyed making this video for you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, maybe give it a thumbs up. As always, run tall, run strong, be kind to one another. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.